Hi friends, good afternoon all. Today I'm here with the topic inequalities. I'll tell you few tricks and how to solve these inequalities within 2 minutes to get 5 marks. Okay, after seeing this minimum 5 out of 5 you will get in 2 minutes. Okay, see the shortcuts till the end of this session. You have to follow, then only you will get this 5 marks. Okay. And this is for sure, you will get, after seeing this session, you will solve all kind of these inequalities. I know most of you all are aware of these inequalities, okay. But anyone can solve these questions using pen and paper. Without using pen and paper, by seeing the screen itself, you have to get 5 marks within 2 minutes, okay. That is the... my main motto of this session. Okay, so I'll tell you the solutions, the methods to solve inequalities by seeing the screen itself. Okay, with basics I have solved 2 questions, and then with higher level difficulty questions I have solved in this session. So see, here we go. See, in input, in questions, if you will get the symbols like this. This is the basic things, okay. Here you have, suppose you take A here, okay. And B, suppose D and C and D, okay. This is the input that we are getting, let us suppose, okay. See, A is greater than B, greater than C, greater than D. So, A is greater than C and A is greater than B. B is greater than C, B is greater than D, C is greater than D. Similarly, in reverse manner, D is less than A, D is less than B, D is less than C. Okay, output will get A to D, it's greater than, okay. This is the forward direction that we are following, A to D. So, we have all greater than symbol. So, output is also a greater than symbol to the A left hand side, whatever may be the symbol they will give you, with A they will follow greater than symbol. In reverse direction they will follow less than symbol, okay. This is the output that we are getting, okay. In between, see here, greater than equal to greater than, so let us say X, Y, Z and P, okay. Then in same way, Y is equals to Z, that we will get. But with this X now, we always get greater than value as a output, okay, in forward direction. If it is in reverse direction with P, with X, P is less than X, okay, opposite symbol of greater than is less than, so we will get P is less than X, okay. So this will be the output that you have to follow, and this is very basics. Maybe if someone is there who is really don't know about this, that is the reason why I am explaining this basics, or else no need of this basics also. You can directly follow my shortcut, but please follow my session till the end, then only you will come to know what is the shortcut that I have for you, okay. Without screen, by seeing the screen itself, without pen paper, you will get 5 marks, okay, after this session. See, they are given like this, means greater than and less than symbol in between any two variables. If we will get this is the closed path. See here, we don't have a path to go in forward direction, as it is showing its backside to us. So whenever we will get two symbols between two variables, if they are asking a relation for relation between these two variables, if the symbol is like this, in between, if we will get this closed path, then directly without checking itself, by seeing the symbols, we will say no relation between them. And same way here also, it is closing the path, okay. So we don't have a relation between these two to go this side, okay. X to Y, let us take X to Y, we can't go because it's a closed path. In the same way, X to Y, we can't go because it's a closed path. So no relation we will write in this case, okay. Hope you understand this better, or else if you want, I'll tell you an example. X is greater than Y, which is greater than X, Z, which is less than P. So they are asking a relation between X and P. See here, X and P. So what we will say, in this case, x to p, if you try to go till here, it's okay, greater than symbol. But if we go after z, it's closing its path, right? To 1 greater than, 1 less than. So what we will say in this case, it's closed path, so we can't go till p. So directly we'll write no relation, okay? And if you will see like this, x is less than y, which is greater than p. In this case also, we will say x and p, no, there is no relation as it is closing the path, okay? Okay, so x and p, no relation. So this is no relation part. Next, I'll tell you one more. See this question. A is greater than B is greater than C is less than D is greater than E is greater than F equal to G, and G is less than H. Okay, I have taken almost all possibles in this. This is the basics one only. This is the problem that I am explaining. Okay, no other problems is the basic one. Okay, so see here, A and F, they are asking A and F relation. See how we will solve. A to F, how we will go? See, till here we are going, okay, it's forward, greater than symbol, it's following, but here it's less than. So before going F itself, it's closing the path here itself in C. See, so after this, with this, after C, it's closing its path. So with A and B, it's closed. So after C now, there will be no relation with this A and B variables. After C, they will not follow any relation as it's closing its path C. Okay, so directly we can say, by seeing this closed symbol itself, we should not go till here. We'll go, after going C itself, we'll say directly it's not follows. It is not following, because A and F directly we can say no relation. Okay, and next, D and E. Okay, it's very basic. Directly, see, D is greater than E. Yeah, it's D is greater than E, by directly it's given here. Fine, it's correct. And see here, is F is less than H. See, F is equals to G. Okay, these whatever the relations with G H is having, that relation will also followed by F. That's why these two are equal. So G is less than H, so F is also less than H. Okay, these two values are equal, that's why it's equal. So F and G will follow less than relation with H. So F is less than H, it's correct. And D and G, they are asking. Okay, D is great. So see here, I have told you, like, follow this forward path rule. Okay, D, okay, fine, like greater than till G we have, and here we, till here we have this greater symbol with F. Anyways, F is equals to G, so obviously G is also follows the same relation as F, so it's D is greater than G, so it's correct. Okay, hope you understand this better. If you have any queries regarding this, please let me know in comment section. If you have any doubts, I'll let you know, I'll clear your doubts. Okay, and next one we'll see. See, for any inequalities, by seeing the before you start your exam itself, I'll give you one tip, small tip. Okay, on your paper, you try to make this box before start of the exam. Okay, then it will be very easy. Okay, if you have good memory power, you try to remember this. Anyways, it's greater than less than symbols itself, so you can memorize it if you can. Okay, see, this is less than and greater than. Less than are equal to, greater than are equal to, and equal symbol. This is the box that we are making to solve the problems easily. Okay, so see here, equal to, less than are equal to. If you have any variables which are having these relations in between, then equal, less than are equal to, if you see, output of that two variables will be less than. Okay, this is less than. Okay, and if you see these two also less than again. Okay, these two also less than. Okay, equal to less than, output is less than, and equal to less than or equal to, in if it is equal and less than or equal, then output will be less than or equal to. Okay, if in case if you see these two, less than or equal to, then output is again a less than. Only one case we will have different answer, that is less than or equal to, less than or equal to, that this is the different one. In only case that is equal and less than or equal to, this is the only case that we are getting different output, it's less than or equal to. In all other cases with these three symbols, we'll get only one output, which is less than. Okay, similarly with greater than or equal to, equal to. Okay, see, if you have this two symbols, equal and greater than, in this case we have greater than output. In these two cases we'll have greater than output. If you have equal and greater than or equal to, only in this case we'll have greater than or equal to as a output for our answer. Okay, why I am saying this, this is the important one that you have to remember. Okay, only then we will solve the questions by seeing the screen itself. Okay, this is important one. If you have any confusion, please let me know. Okay, I'll take one more session if you want also. Okay, and see here, one more thing from this box itself. Okay, if you have any symbol like less than, greater than, so it is a closed path, though then no relation between those two variables which were given. Okay, if you have similarly in this case also, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, in between two variables, if we'll get this, then no relation we can say by closing our eyes itself, we can say between two variables these two symbols are there, so no relation. Okay, and even these two also, greater than, less than or equal to, no relation, no relation, no relation. Okay, no relation, no relation. Okay, if you take these two, greater than, if you take these two, less than, if you take these two, greater than, these two, less than. Okay, so this is the basic thing that we have to see. And if you have any suppose, okay, I'll tell you this while solving the problems itself, or else if I'll say this now, you will be confusing, you will thought something different it is, so I can't see this anymore, that's why. So I don't want to confuse you now, I'll tell you the shortcut while solving the problems. Okay, see here, A is greater than B, greater than C, greater than D. E is greater than C, greater than F, less than G. Okay, fine. These are the two questions that we have been asked here. Okay, see here. And they are asking us, A is less than F. Fine, A is here and F we have here. Okay, they are asking the relation. So we have to find out a common factor for this two. What we have here, C here we have here, and also similarly C we have here. So they are asking us to find the relation between A and F. So by this common factor, based on this common factor, we'll try to solve the relation between, we'll try to find out the relation between A and F. Fine. Okay. So see here, A to F forward rule, you remember. So forward till here we have what we are getting between A and C. It's greater than, greater than. So what I have told you, if you have two greater than, it's greater than as the output for first one. And see here, we have here, it's C to F, no? F relation, no? So C to F, what we have? C to F is also a forward one, that we are getting a greater than symbol here, right? So first one output is greater than, second one output is greater than. So greater than is always A is greater than F that we are getting. Okay, directly you can say simply here, by seeing here, A is greater than C and C is greater than F. Obviously say A is greater than F. What we have here? Here we have A is less than F. But what we are getting greater than answer. So what we'll say simply, A is less than F, which is wrong. A is greater than F, which is right. Okay, less than F, so wrong we have taken here. And one more, see, D is less than E. Is it correct or not? We have to see. D is here and E is here. Fine. So what is the common factor that we have here? D to C and C to E we have to find. So common factor here again, it's C. So D to C, how we are going? It's reverse direction, right? reverse direction. So what is the if it is forward, it is greater than. If it is reverse, no, always greater than is, what is the opposite for greater than is less than. Okay, what is the opposite for this greater than or equal to is less than or equal to. Same way, for less than, greater than is the opposite. Less than or equal to, greater than or equal to is the opposite one. If it is in backward direction, we have to take opposite direction. If it is forward direction, same we have to take. Equality, opposite is always a equal one. So with this equal, it's like a neutral thing that we don't consider. I mean, we have to consider it, but it's a neutral part. Okay, it will not make any problem or confusion for us. Equal is our friend. Okay, so it will not make any problem for us. So equal is a good friend. Fine. And see here, and it's D2C, it's in reverse. One second.